So to access the Paint tool in Storyboard Pro, you can go to the Tools toolbar and select its icon, which is this paint bucket, or go to the top menu and select Tools, Paint, or use a keyboard shortcut listed beside. So painting is as easy as selecting a swatch from the swatches section, or changing a color if you'd like to change the color a bit, and then clicking on the closed zone of a drawing in the stage view. So right away we can see that the eye was not a closed zone, so it allowed paint to come in. If you'd like to avoid that problem, what you can do is from the Tools Property panel of the Paint tool, you can click on this button here, which is the Close Gaps button, and select perhaps something like Close Large Gap. The tolerance for the gap can be changed in the field beside, either by using the slider that appears when you click on the double-headed arrow, or by typing one in directly. Now if you try to paint the same zone, you'll see that it doesn't fill in the eye. So the first property in the Tools Property panel for the Paint tool is whether you want to have a marquee or a lasso for your cursor. With the Marquee tool, you can paint both a line and a zone, so basically anything that is within the marquee frame. You can do the same thing with the Lasso tool and in fact make a more precise selection. The next selection allows you to choose between the regular Paint tool or the Paint Unpainted or the Unpaint tool. So the Paint Unpainted allows you to very quickly paint zones that have not been painted yet. So if we just quickly hide Selena's spacesuit and we change to the marquee, now with the Paint Unpainted, I can select her whole head, but the lines will not get painted because they were already painted. They were already painted black. So it really quickly filled in any other zone that did not have paint in it. The Unpaint tool, of course, does the opposite. If I select all of this though, everything will disappear because it'll unpaint both the black lines and the zones. You can use the Marquee tool just like the Lasso tool to click into specific regions, so that also will unpaint specific areas. And I'll just undo all of that and go back to the regular Paint tool. The next option is the Apply to Visible Drawings button. So if I click this and I turn on Selena's costume again, you have to notice that the zone for her helmet and the zone where her face is overlap. So if I decide to click on her helmet layer and then click in the center of both these two zones, you'll see that they're both painted. And we know this because we can see it here in the thumbnail view. Even if I hide her spacesuit, you can see that her face was still painted because it was directly underneath the same zone as the helmet. And I'll undo that as well. So the next options apply to bitmap layers, which we don't have any of here. So I'll create one quickly by clicking on the Add Bitmap Layer button from the Layers toolbar. And then what I'm going to do is just quickly select the brush tool and create two different squares. So I'm going to create one with two different texture brushes. So I'm just going to grab the Paint tool again. And actually for this example, I need a second color for the fill. So maybe something like that. And then I'm going to zoom in a bit so that you can really see these examples. So in the Tools Property panel, what I'm going to do is bring all the sliders down for the bitmap options to start like that. So I'm going to fill these two rectangles, and right away we see something funny. We see a white border separating the fill from its outline, and this is in both cases. And this has something to do with the alpha. So if I undo that, and I increase the alpha, and I repaint these layers, you'll see that automatically something has happened, and that's that the fill now comes all the way to meet the outline. So the alpha has something to do with how many transparent pixels there are between a bitmap fill and its bitmap outline. So I'm going to undo that one more time. So now if we look at the maximum overlap and we increase it, let's say to the maximum, and we fill these two rectangles, something else has occurred, and that's that not only does the color meet the border surrounding it, but it blends better into the border, sometimes coming quite far in and over the edges of that border to create a nicer blend. Because if you remember, even with the alpha being higher, you still see kind of a weird white border going around. And in here you can see that there's kind of like white holes or spots around the border as well. So that maximum overlap is the overlap between these two colors and how much allowance there is for an overlap. So the color tolerance only really takes effect when you're repainting a zone. So if I select a different color and then fill in these zones one more time, you'll see that you can still see the previous color that was there before, so it didn't do a very good job repainting that zone. And that's because the tolerance right now is extremely low, it's zero. If we then undo that again and increase the color tolerance to the maximum, which is 50, and try that again, you'll see that the blending looks much better. And the last and final option is the anti-aliasing. So let me actually make those white again so that you can see the best example here. And maybe even bring the alpha down a bit. So right now there's anti-aliasing applied to this fill. So even though you can kind of see some jagged pixely lines, relatively speaking, they're not that bad. There's sort of a softening going on. So if I undo that and then turn the anti-aliasing off and repaint the inside of that rectangle, now you'll see what happens when there is no anti-aliasing, and that's that there is quite a jagged edge with these little steps surrounding this fill.